द स्टोरी ऑफ विलेज पालमपुर ओवरव्यू द पर्पस ऑफ द स्टोरी इज टू इंट्रोड्यूस सम बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स रिलेटिंग टू प्रोडक्शन एंड दिस वी डू थ्रू अ स्टोरी ऑफ अ हाइपोथेटिकल विलेज कॉल्ड पालमपुर फार्मिंग इज द मेन एक्टिविटी इन पालमपुर वेरस सेवरल अदर एक्टिविटीज सच एज स्मॉल स्केल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग डेयरी ट्रांसपोर्ट एट्सेट्रा आर कैरिड आउट ऑन अ लिमिटेड स्केल These production activities need various types of resources, natural resources, man-made items, human effort, money, etc. As we read through the story of Palampur, we will learn how various resources combine to produce the desired goods and services in the village. Introduction. Palampur is well connected with neighboring villages and towns. Raniganj, a big village, is 3 kilometers from Palampur. An all-weather road connects the village to Raniganj and further on to the nearest small town of Shahpur. Many kinds of transport are visible on this road, starting from bullock carts, tungas, bogies, loaded with jaggery and other commodities, to motor vehicles like motorcycles, jeeps, tractors and trucks. This village has about 450 families belonging to several different castes. The 80 upper caste families own the majority of land in the village. Their houses, some of them quite large, are made of brick with cement plastering. The SCs comprise 1/3 of the population and live in one corner of the village and in much smaller houses, some of which are mud and straw. Most of the houses have electric connections. Electricity passes all the tube wells in the fields and is used in various types of small business. Palampur has 2 primary schools and 1 high school. There is a primary health center run by the government and 1 private dispensary where the sick are treated. The description above shows that Palampur has fairly well-developed system of roads, transport, electricity, irrigation, schools and health center. Compare these facilities with those in your nearby village. The story of Palampur, an imaginary village, will take us through the different types of production activities in the village. In villages across India, farming is the main production activity. The other production activities referred to as non-farm activities include small manufacturing, transport, shopkeeping, etc. We shall take a look at both these types of activities after learning a few general things about production. Organization of production. The aim of production is to produce the goods and services that we want. There are 4 requirements for production of goods and services. The first requirement is land and other natural resources such as water, forests, minerals. The second requirement is labor, that is, people who will do the work. Some production activities require highly educated workers to perform. The necessary tasks. Other activities require workers who can do manual work. Each worker is providing the labor necessary for production. The third requirement is physical capital, that is, the variety of inputs required at every stage during production. What are the items that come under physical capital? A. Tools, machines, buildings. Tools and machines range from very simple tools such as a farmer's plow to sophisticated machines such as generators, turbines, computers, etc. Tools, machines, buildings can be used in production over many years and are called fixed capital. B. Raw materials and money in hand. Production requires a variety of raw materials such as the yarn used by the weaver and the clay used by the potter. Also, some money is always required during production to make payments and buy other necessary items. Raw materials and money in hand are called working capital. Unlike tools, machines and buildings, these are used up in production. There is a fourth requirement too. You will need knowledge and enterprise to be able to put together land, labor and physical capital and produce an output either to use yourself or to sell in the market. This these days is called human capital. We shall learn more about human capital in the next chapter. In the picture, identify the land, labor and fixed capital used in production. Picture 1.2, a factory with several laborers and machines. Every production is organized by combining land, labor, physical capital and human capital, which are known as factors of production. As we read through the story of Palampur, we will learn more about the first three factors of production. For convenience, we will refer to the physical capital as the capital in this chapter. Farming in Palampur. 1. Land is fixed. Farming is the main production activity in Palampur. 75% of the people who are working are dependent on farming for their livelihood. They could be farmers or farm laborers. The well-being of these people is closely related to production on the farms. But remember that there is a basic constraint in raising farm production. Land area under cultivation is practically fixed. Since 1960 in Palampur, there has been no expansion in land area under cultivation. By then, some of the waste lands in the village had been converted to cultivable land. There exists no further scope to increase farm production by bringing new land under cultivation. The standard unit of measuring land is hectare. Though in the villages you may find land area being discussed in local units such as biga, guinta, etc. 1 hectare equals the area of a square with one side measuring 100 meters. Can you compare the area of a 1 hectare field with the area of your school ground? 2. Is there a way one can grow more from the same land? In the kind of crops grown and facilities available, Palampur would resemble a village of the western part of the state of Uttar Pradesh. All land is cultivated in Palampur. No land is left idle. During the rainy season, Kharif, farmers grow jowar and bajra. These plants are used as cattle feed. It is followed by cultivation of potato between October and December. In the winter season, Rabi, fields are sown with wheat. From the wheat produced, farmers keep enough wheat for the family's consumption and sell the surplus wheat at the market at Raniganj. A part of the land area is also devoted to sugarcane, which is harvested once every year. Sugarcane, in its raw form or as jaggery, is sold to traders in Shahpur. Is there a way one can grow more from the same land? In the kind of crops grown and facilities available, Palampur would resemble a village of the western part of the state, Uttar Pradesh. All land is cultivated in Palampur. No land is left idle. During the rainy season, Kharif, farmers grow jowar and bajra. These plants are used as cattle feed. It is followed by cultivation of potato between October and December. In the winter season, Rabi, fields are sown with wheat. From the wheat produced, farmers keep enough wheat for the family's consumption and sell the surplus wheat at the market at Raniganj. A part of the land area is also devoted to sugarcane, which is harvested once every year. Sugarcane, in its raw form or as jaggery, is sold to traders in Shahpur. The main reason why farmers are able to grow three different crops in a year in Palampur is due to the well-developed system of irrigation. Electricity came early to Palampur. Its major impact was to transform the system of irrigation. Persian wheels were till then used by farmers to draw water from the wells and irrigate small fields. People saw that the electric run tube wells could irrigate much larger areas of land more effectively. The first few tube wells were installed by the government. Soon, however, farmers started setting up private tube wells. As a result, by mid-1970s, the entire cultivated area of 200 hectares was irrigated. Not all villages in India have such high levels of irrigation. Apart from the riverine plains, coastal regions in our country are well irrigated. In contrast, plateau regions such as the Deccan Plateau have low levels of irrigation. Of the total cultivated area in the country, a little less than 40% is irrigated even today. In the remaining areas, farming is largely dependent on rainfall. To grow more than one crop on a piece of land during the year is known as multiple cropping. It is the most common way of increasing production on a given piece of land. All farmers in Palampur grow at least two main crops. Many are growing potato as a third crop in the past 15 to 20 years. Table 1.1 shows the land under cultivation in India in units of million hectares. Plot this on the graph provided. What does the graph show? Discuss in class. Cultivated area over the years. 1950, 120 million hectare. 1960, 130 million hectare. 1970, 140 million hectare. 1980, 140 million hectare. 1990, 140 million hectare. 2000, 140 million hectare. 2010, 155 million hectare. 2012, 155 million hectares. Source: The State of Indian Agriculture 2015-16, Directorate of Economics and Statistics, Department of Agriculture, Cooperation and Farmers Welfare.